Petals are if physical condition. So it means, right, 1 minute.
Condition. So this petals are physical condition is known as the gamopetalus.
Petals are physical condition that is known as the gamopetalus. So polypetalus, it means petals are free condition, right? So petals are physical condition is known as the gamopetalus. So for example, in gamopetalus, so we observe that it means China rose.
For example, China rose,
right? So after then,
Datura.
China rose are most of that, so solanaceae family present, but condition is known as the aestivation. What is the definition of aestivation? The arrangement of sepals and petals, it means the perianth. When the flower is present, bud condition, so that is known as that aestivation process. Aestivation mainly 4 types of that aestivation. So what is that? First one is the valvate aestivation. So in valvate aestivation means what is that? So observe this diagram. In this, these are the perianth. This perianths are arranged closely. They do not overlapping, okay, without fizzing. So all are present without overlapping. So the type of aestivation is known as the valvate aestivation. Example, anon of calyx and calotrophis of calyx. So calotrophis of calyx or anon of calyx showing of that valvate aestivation. Okay. So next, after that, twisted aestivation. In twisted aestivation, so it means it is a perianth. One perianth of margin is outside, one is inside. One is outside, one is inside. Totally 5. So complete overlapping. So in this one, one margin is outside, one margin is inside. One margin is inside, one margin is outside. So this type of aestivation is known as that twisted aestivation. It is complete overlapping. So what is the objective bit? Identify that. So which aestivation is completely overlapped? It means twisted aestivation. Without overlapping, valvate aestivation. So example, China rose, it means hibiscus, scientific name, cotton and lady's finger. After that, imbricate aestivation. So in the imbricate aestivation, the overlapping is not occur, it means it is not regular, it is a particular direction is not present in the imbricate aestivation. So in this 1+1+3 condition, it is the object bit. For example, one perianth of 2 margins are completely inside, that is the one. Remaining one perianth of 2 margins are completely outside. Okay, so remaining one is out, one is in, one is out, one is in, one is out, one is in. So that is known as a imbricate aestivation. So this overlapping of perianths, so and it does not having particular direction, so this imbricate aestivation. Example, Cassia and Gulmohar. Okay, Cassia and Gulmohar is an example for that imbricate aestivation. After the vaxillary aestivation, vaxillary aestivation showing of that papilionaceous corolla. Papilionaceous corolla. So about that, largest perianth is present, it is the largest petal, that is known as the vexillum. It is overlapping, so it means before of that, it means in front of that 2 petals, so they are known as the wing petal. So this overlapping, so it means in the 2 petals are physical condition, so that is known as that carina or keel petals. So it means at that, this vexillary aestivation, so vexillum is overlapping to the wing petals are overlapping to the keel petals. It is also known as a descendingly imbricate aestivation. Descendingly imbricate aestivation. These are the 4 types of aestivation. So example, vexillary aestivation, P, this example, P, bean, it means a Fabaceae
family of corolla, papillaceous corolla, right?
So these are that different types of that aestivation.